Shalom, Chavrim. I'm Stephen Benoon. You're watching Israeli News Live in a world of Ein Shalom. There is no peace whatsoever, and we have some very troubling information coming out this morning. As we got we saw a tweet here this morning. Russia is strengthening its air defense capabilities in Syria today. The two more of the S-400 complexes were deployed in Syria, providing a reliable anti-aircraft defense in Khamamim, Tartarus, General Shoigu has actually announced. This was also brought out on RT's video there, as you saw there. But really the question comes up is what's happening in Syria and why is all this happening? As we reported the other day with Lorenzo and Already Happened, he had shared that the U.S. was moving the MIM-104 Patriot anti-missile defense battery system. And he said it definitely looks like it's going to the Middle East there as we watch the ship, the cargo ship from Germany, go around Spain, headed in. He did confirm that the ship landed in Israel, the final destination thus far. Will the Patriot battery be used in Israel to help protect Israel from a possible all-out war in the Middle East, or will it actually be deployed to help protect U.S. soldiers inside of eastern Syria? That is still remains to be seen exactly what's going to happen there. But we have to ask ourselves the question, why is the U.S. and Russia deploying new assets into the region there? What do they know that we don't know? All right, now Turkish, we know that the Turkish actions, according here to RT, in Syria distract from efforts to defeat ISIS. This is the U.S. Defensive Secretary James Mattis is stating about this issue here. But something more sinister is in the works here, and I really believe that what Turkey is doing inside of Syria right now is actually in cooperation with a NATO effort. And maybe even the deep state was using President Trump to play the hand with the Kurds to make it look like that Turkey was justifying their entrance because he's angry over the U.S.'s alliance with the Kurds. And at the same time, the Kurds have been working on a closer alliance with Damascus, working with President Bashar al-Assad, which would strengthen Syria's resolve in taking back their country from all the different militant groups fighting in that region. Now, as we've looked at this, and of course, as we have mentioned before, don't forget, I've always believed that the coup was a staged coup. I'm not the only one to think that. There's actually officers inside the Turkish military that were not with Gulen Fagan there that have also come to the same conclusion. But if you remember, too, when the United States used the Tomahawk cruise missiles against the Syrian government for the alleged chemical weapons attack, some 59 cruise missiles were launched. Erdogan, he states, U.S. strike against Syria regime welcome, but not enough. Now, that's kind of a little bit of a different take when Erdogan is supposed to be an ally of Russia now, but don't forget he is a NATO member, so that's a dangerous serpent to be playing with for President Putin, thinking he has an ally when the serpent is ready to strike. And now we see that Turkey has moved in against Afrin, attacking the Kurds in the northern region. Well, if Erdogan is really so angry at President Trump for making this military agreement with the Kurds on the eastern side of the Euphrates, why is he attacking the Kurds in Afrin on the northern side of Syria, completely away from the area that that the U.S. was working with? That lets me know something majorly is up and not what we think is up. Again, as I said, though, I'm not the only guy that thinks that the coup was a fake. Michael Rubin wrote an article here, Turkish officer speaks Erdogan may have staged the coup. This is the very military officers that have actually compiled their own information in this report here and publicly posted it, that they're concerned about the evidence, that the coup clearly was something that Erdogan was well aware of and pretty much in advance. So there's much more that meets the eye than you can imagine. So now let's swing back and look what came out only about an hour ago from Heather Narat, about at the State Department there, about what's going on and what may be the real cause for all the new deployment of military assets in the region there. Says here, Secretary Tillerson is quoted, there is no denying Russia has breached its commitment and betrayed the Chemical Weapons Convention and UN Resolution 2018 by shielding its allied Syria. Whoever conducted the attacks, Russia ultimately bears responsibility for countless Syrian victims of chemical weapons. Now, Heather goes on to note on here, Secretary Tillerson, this initiative puts those who ordered and carried out chemical weapons attack on notice. You will face a day of reckoning for your crimes against humanity, and your victims will see justice done. That's serious, friends. And they've already, Secretary Tillerson has put the blame on Russia. Russia moving in its own air defense system. I said to you a little while back there, what were they doing with these little 13 drones that they sent in? They were looking to see if Russia had the capability to defend itself in the event of an all-out air attack. And Russia failed to meet that demand. Now we see this threat from Secretary Tillerson about the chemical weapons attack, which, by the way, the proof has been overwhelming that the chemical weapons attack was never carried out by the Syrian government, nor Russia, but rather by Al-Qaeda and Al-Nusra militants that are operating in the area. Same thing back in 2013. It was never Syria. Erdogan, who is, the Turkish Parliament member Aaron Erdem, who came out and clearly, with all the evidence presented before the Turkish Parliament, had Turkey allowing Syrian ISIS militants move in through their country, bringing the ISIS, sarin gas that was from the attack over in Libya being brought through their country, and then again used right about the same time that the sarin gas attack happened inside of Syria that killed so many civilians. And again, blamed on the Syrian government, just like this case down in Shakun, I believe, is in the province that happened there. Everyone trying to point that finger over there towards President Bashar al-Assad and his government for doing these chemical attacks. And even though they are staged, they are going to use them to justify this renewed campaign against Syria. I can tell you something, friends. That King of the North, and as I have said before, it's nothing but a reinsurgent of the Nephilim, and maybe Rome and this whole NATO empire is being ran by this, as the former Secretary of Defense of Canada states, it's really being run by a bunch of aliens, a bunch of demons that are running this system. And so they definitely have their head. That King of the North, the Melech HaTzifon, a hidden king, the hidden hand, they're going against Syria, and they're going to take Russia out if they get in the way. And Russia, seemingly, is preparing to at least protect their own. I'm Stephen Benoon. You're watching Israeli News Live. Troubling news coming out today out of the Middle East. And so sorry to be the bearer of bad news. Shalom. In a world of ain't shalom, there is no peace.